Hey, what's up, guys? Josiah here with EasyCaters.com, and I wanted to do a real short video on how to increase the speed of your Thinkorswim platform. I know I've had trouble recently with my Mac version of Thinkorswim. With a recent update they released, it really seemed to get bogged down and slow and really unresponsive. And so I've been trying to solve that problem recently, and I've seen lots of tricks in the past, some of which didn't really seem to work for me. But I wanted to go over all the different options that are available for you to try things that can help speed up your system and get around issues that you're having. So the first thing, which is one of the easiest things you can do, is just go over to the help screen in Thinkorswim, to the system page, and click collect garbage. This will clear out the memory and basically just free up some memory space on your system. This happens on its own automatically during the day, but and I haven't really seen this help a whole lot, but this is one option that's available. If you're getting bogged down, you can go over here and click collect garbage, and that will potentially help in your situation. The next thing, this is mostly for those of you who are going to be like swing traders or longer term investors or traders. You can, and this is the opposite of what they normally tell you in the articles and so forth about Thinkorswim. You can actually turn down the quote speed. So if we go into application settings and go to system, we can change. So we have options here for how fast we receive the quotes. So real time would mean no delay. Fast means max delay 1 second, and so forth. So if you're a long-term trader, you really don't need every second, every tick, you know, that kind of thing. And the closer you get to real time here, the more resources in your system you're going to be eating up, managing all those quotes coming in second by second. So if you can turn this down, and most people tell you to turn it up because they think that's going to make it look more responsive, but actually it's taking up more system resources. And so that's actually going to be making your system slower. So what I would suggest for those of you that are not day traders and so forth, or for, you know, if you're a swing trader or longer term, then you could turn this down to maybe moderate or fast, something like that. If you're really long term, you could turn it down farther than that even. And actually, I've found that, you know, a lot of trading is based on emotion, and not having the stock, you know, jittering right in front of you seeing every little tick, you know, making you, oh, is this position going to work or not? You know, that kind of thing. Sometimes just having the quotes coming in at a slow, gradual, you know, really steady pace, and not really seeing every single little movement that it makes, sometimes that can actually help in your trading. So, you know, you might even just consider it for psychological purposes, not just for speeding up your system. So anyway, there's a quick suggestion for longer term traders. And so you can just set this to whatever you think you can deal with. You can play around with different settings, hit apply and see how they work for you, and go from there. So that's number two. So the next potential thing you can do is I'm going to close out of my system here and restart it. And so you can go in here to the launch screen, and we can adjust the minimum and maximum memory allotment. If we go into settings here, we have a memory usage minimum and maximum setting. So mine are set kind of high. depending on your system, depending on how much RAM you have in your system, how much memory, you might want to adjust these differently than me. But the main one that actually matters is this maximum memory that you're going to be allotting to Thinkorswim. And So just set that according to what you think would work best for your system based on how much RAM you have. So, and just keep in mind that, you know, like 6,000 megabytes is the same thing as 6 gigabytes, essentially. So that's how that works. So if you have, you know, 8 gigabytes of RAM, then 6 gigabytes might be a good maximum, or 4 gigabytes, something like that. So that's one option. Another couple of quick thoughts on just your general system. So, you know, it may be that your system is actually just not capable of handling the latest versions of Thinkorswim, and so you might need to upgrade your system or something like that. Another thing you can do is actually conserve your local system's resources by reducing the number of I have 3 monitors on my system, so that's using up a lot of graphics processing power, and so I can conserve that power by only using 2 screens or reducing the resolution of each screen. So I have like a couple of 5K monitors. I can turn those to a lower resolution, and that will use up less processing power and from the graphics card. So that's another option. You can also make sure you're not running as many programs simultaneously and that kind of thing, and you have all the bells and whistles in your main, you know, your system, whether it's Windows or Mac or whatever, that you have all those extra bells and whistles that you don't need turned off so that you spare resources for Thinkorswim. So, and actually I don't need to get back into the platform here. The next thing that you can do is you can clear out your user GUI get into it here. Application. So I'm going to go to Thinkorswim. In a PC, you're going to go to Program Files and Thinkorswim, and then you'll see this User GUI folder. And so what you can do, and before you do this, what I would do is actually just copy your whole TDA folder or Thinkorswim folder. Make a duplicate of it as a backup. All your indicators and that kind of thing are usually going to be backed up by Thinkorswim itself and stored with your username. But some of the local items will be only in this folder. So you want to create a backup of this, before you proceed to these next couple of options to be sure that you don't damage anything beyond repair. So. These next two options are a little bit more technical, a little bit more dangerous, that, you know, you could mess something up if you don't know what you're doing. So, but anyway, if you go to your, you know, Windows Program Files or your Mac Applications folder, go to your Thinkorswim folder and find the User GUI folder, you can actually just drag this to the trash, to the recycle bin, or on a Mac, you can hit Command Delete, and that will delete it. And so then the next time you launch Thinkorswim, it will rebuild that folder automatically. And essentially that just clears out a bunch of junk. If you have a lot of extra data that's been downloaded or cached files and that kind of stuff, it clears all that out. And you'll notice that there's a little bit of a performance bump that you get by clearing all that stuff out of the system. And actually, this is the main thing that I've found that actually helps my system run a little bit better. So I would definitely suggest trying this after you create a backup of your Thinkorswim folder. Try deleting that user GUI and see if that improves the system or the platform speed for you, because it seemed to do that for me pretty well. The next one I actually haven't had much success with, but I think a lot of other people have. And so I wanted to show what you can do in that case, in case this will be beneficial for any of you. It wasn't for me, really. But what you can do is go into your Thinkorswim VM options file, which is also in that Thinkorswim folder in your program files. And you can open this up in a text editor. And you're basically just going to copy and paste this text over top of what's already there. and you're going to save it and overwrite the original one. And so this is supposed to optimize your system in certain ways. You'll notice up here, it has some settings for XMX and XMS. These are actually your min and max RAM settings. 2048 megabytes, 1024 megabytes is the minimum. So actually what I have set is 6144 and 256. So you can ignore those. You can just leave them how they were. But so these are just some preferences that you're setting in the actual kind of a configuration or options file for Thinkorswim directly. And I don't know a lot about this. I know a lot of people have said they've experienced a performance boost by using these preferences. So if that helps, I'm going to include the text in the description of the video for you to copy and paste over. Just again, be sure you make a backup of your folder before you do that, because this is a little bit more, you know, tampering with the nitty-gritty details of the platform. You don't want to do that without creating a backup of your system first. So anyway, I'll post this text for you to copy and paste in the video. Hopefully these ideas will be of benefit to someone out there. And I know for me, like I said, the deleting the user GUI folder and letting it be rebuilt by the platform when I launched the next time, that seemed to give me the biggest performance boost. Along with, of course, just when I upgraded my internet to 100, I think it's 100 megabits. When I got fiber for the first time, that definitely helped my system out a little bit as well. So, sometimes, these little tricks that can help speed up your platform, eventually you might need to just go ahead and upgrade your system in general or increase your internet speed, that kind of thing. But hopefully these will be of help to you. And if so, please consider hitting subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and give us some feedback below in the comments section. And be sure to check us out at easycaters.com. And we will talk to you next time.